Oi there, lads and lassies, welcome back to another episode of the Blindness Podcast. Actually, I was about to say you guys are my first guest since having guests from the whole COVID-19, but actually I had Rick before that. But now I have his partner in crime, his,
leading lady.
Clyde.
Yeah. I was trying to think which one's the guy, Bonnie or Clyde. So I was like, his Clyde, his Bonnie, whichever one.
Wait, Bonnie or Clyde? Who's the dude?
Girl.
Bonnie's the girl.
Then you're Clyde, because you wear the pants in that relationship.
I'm a bitch. I guess.
Because she has more balls than you, Rick.
The girl gets down. Have you seen the movie Bonnie and Clyde on Netflix?
She's
Boom!
Bro, if I even told you guys the movies I haven't seen, you guys are going to fucking get mad. Because Rick's seen a lot of gangster movies that are old school movies that I haven't seen. Like,
I've seen a few here and there.
Like, a classic one that I haven't seen and I heard is so good. No, is Goodfellas. Have you guys seen that one?
Yeah, I've seen that. Have you?
Yeah.
Have you seen it?
No.
You're trying to check me. Shit.
Rick's seen every gangster movie out there.
Everyone.
But I heard that's such a good movie. Everyone always makes references about it and how good it is, and I've never
Was
seen
it. Goodfellas?
Goodfellas.
Fellas.
Fellas.
But have you seen Blood and Blood Out?
Mm-hmm.
I've seen that one.
I think everyone's
seen American Me.
Yes, I've seen that one. Have you guys seen, like, the Godfather movies?
Yes.
No.
I haven't seen any of those either.
Nope.
And I heard they're so good.
After
I heard
all the mafia movies you've seen, you have not watched the Godfather.
I just.
Or how about Scarface?
Scarface.
I haven't seen Scarface.
No.
I've seen the first 10 minutes where he like kills someone in the fucking hotel bathroom. You know, I think that's the opening scene, right?
That's all you've seen?
Yep.
It's you haven't even watched it. People spoiler alert.
I know.
Say
I mean, hello to my little friend.
I've seen that scene on YouTube, but I haven't, like, seen the whole movie. And there's a big difference.
You're going to want to become, like, a fucking mobster in Miami or Vice. And
I already want to become a mobster. I just don't have the balls to do all the shit that they do.
Very true.
Bro, I don't even have a boss to kick the homeless out of this fucking hallway. What do you guys all do?
He's an awkward confrontation.
So basically what happened is we're all chilling here one night, just so you guys can see how much of a pussy I am. And we're hanging out here in the office. And then I went outside to go check out on one of our friends. And then when I went out there, this homeless guy was coming up the steps. And then my friend, who was already downstairs, he said, "Kenny, fucking stop that guy. Stop the guy." And I'm like, "What? What are you talking about?" Like, you know, and then granted, he didn't look like a homeless guy. He just looked like a beaner with like bad hygiene or something, you know? And then I guess he had like a 40 on his hand, but I was looking at him from the left side. So he had it hidden right here. And then he like pretended like he was reading what's on the door. And Mario's like, "Fucking stop him, Kenny." And then he saw me and we kind of just looked at each other for like 3 seconds. Basically, like, we were both deciding, like, wait, what is this person going to do? And then he just turned around and walked away. And
I wish I was there.
I didn't do shit. I didn't know what the fuck was going on.
I wanted to witness that.
I mean, I've said it a bunch on here that I'm a big bitch, so.
Yeah, he has said that.
Doesn't fucking matter. Doesn't. at least you said it. I was thinking it, but you said it.
I didn't.
White Chicks. When they're singing the song. Have you guys seen White Chicks, right?
Yeah, not. I don't remember.
Have you seen White Chicks? I was about to say, you are one.
If you didn't hear that, I'm white.
But the part where they're in the car and then, like, they're singing, "Walking My Way Downtown." And then they switch it to the song where it goes, "Pump it." And then they're like, they don't want to say the N-word. No, one of them says it. And she's like, "Oh my god, you just said it." And she's like, "Well, nobody's around." She's like, "Well, you thought it." And I was like, Oh my god, well, you said it.
Yeah, I need to watch it.
That movie's freaking hilarious.
I have, I just don't remember.
Oh, that movie's fucking hilarious, too.
If it's not on Netflix, it was recently.
Us Mexicans know the sites online. Like, movie 1, 2, 3.
Oh, the hacker movies?
I know, that's
what I'm
saying.
We can not.
I just leaked one, movie 1, 2, 3. But whatever.
That doesn't work anymore, does it?
Well, just type in movie 1, 2, 3, and then a couple links come out, and just click the first one. And
After you get all these viruses on your fucking shit.
I have a Mac, so I don't have to worry about that.
Yeah, that's what they want you to think.
Look at them closely.
Look at these hackers fucking watching your every move. You know what's funny? Oh, yeah. Did you guys try looking at the video Brock sent? No,
not at all.
No, they were talking about how everything we have is everything we have, it's being spied on. Everything, our phones and everything.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I know. When I say something into my phone that I have not looked Trip. Up on the internet, it will pop up on my
Oh,
phone
you haven't
pad.
Looked it up?
I've,
so
yep.
if I'm talking to Rick or somebody about either, like, we were talking about vegan donuts the other day.
Just a keyword.
Or just a keyword.
Mm-hmm.
And I have not typed it into my search bar anywhere, not on social media, not on the internet. It will pop up with an ad for that exact
oh,
thing
shit.
I talked about.
That's yep. I've never
trend, dude.
Noticed
fucking
that.
Trip.
No, like we went to a vegan donut place in Costa Mesa, and I did not hashtag or tag the vegan donut shop, which we got them, but it was a raspberry vegan donut that I took a picture of
mm-hmm.
at the place, and then had ads on my phone for a raspberry.
And all you
donut.
Did was take a picture of it?
All I did was take a picture.
I mean, it probably has like facial, like that facial recognition. So, like, it had a donut recognition.
It had a donut,
you know?
Donut recognition. No,
well, have you guys heard of LiDAR?
No.
Isn't LiDAR like it scans
I've heard
the
of
room?
Gator.
No. Wow. My senses are getting stronger.
So, what's the LiDAR?
A LiDAR is pretty much like, I don't know the full name of it, but what it is scans a room and it observes the like the measurements and the height, length, width, or whatever it is, and you go based off of that. So, like, if you want to add a couch to like the room,
mm-hmm.
you get the LiDAR in the, I guess, the app or application, and then you put it on there and you can see how it is before you even buy it.
Like, oh, you see how it's going to fit in your room?
Yeah, right, right.
The phone literally detects the entire height. You just go like this. It scans the room. It scans every dimension in the room. And then say you want to put a couch, a table, or something.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It will pop that virtual image up, and you can move it around.
Oh, Amazon has it.
Ooh,
Amazon has it.
Saying.
But, like, crazy. It's crazy how that is happening right now. But, like, how Emily was saying, she took a picture of that raspberry donut.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, our technology now, like,
yeah,
just
yeah.
scans the fucking donut. And, oh, hey, here's a raspberry mm-hmm.
donut.
I was like, enjoy this advertisement for free.
Damn.
Dude.
You know, after I saw the video and, like, was doing that shit, I'm like, I'm just going to keep cussing at my phone. Like, hoping that they're, like, listening to it. So every time I'm going to be like, hey, fuck you guys. Fuck this bullshit, you know, it's weird because every time, like, I get these ads on YouTube when I'm listening to something or like a podcast mm-hmm. or something, and it's like, it's been State Farm a lot lately. I don't know what's with fucking State Farm.
You're like Jake, that's
what yeah. that new Jake, it's a new
He's
guy.
He's wearing khakis.
Yeah, yeah. And I'll be cussing State Farm out, hoping that they're listening to this. I'm like, fuck you, State Farm. I don't give a fuck what you guys are selling me. Blah, blah, blah. Get the fuck out of here, you know? And, dude, it's crazy how these people are like, are fucking.
Nope, I do the exact same thing. I'll yell at it and be like, why don't you give me an ad for
such
if you're listening?
Vegan donuts.
Nah, she'll be like, give me an ad of a sexy girl or this and that. I'm like, what the fuck?
Wait,
I
want to
know if they're listening. That's sexy
Oh, like something
like,
random.
Yeah, yeah.
That
oh,
you never search for
exactly.
to see.
Exactly.
Like,
give me an ad, you know? And like, purposefully don't give me an ad.
Yeah,
but
dude.
I can imagine you saying that. Fuck you, State Farm.
Yeah,
the person right next to you, I'm like, what the fuck is this guy doing?
Fucking calls like, I want to cancel my membership.
According to this guy, he said, fuck State Farm, so I'm going by what this guy says.
Yeah, dude, the fucking thing that these motherfuckers are, like, hacking us. Like, yeah,
yeah.
basically hacking us, you know? Like, listening to everything we're freaking doing.
Well, look at fucking Anonymous, man.
Oh, yeah. I never really understood what they do.
They leak out secrets that government is hiding from us, and
so they're like for the people.
Yeah, so like if, like, for example, they recently came up
mm-hmm.
and they're I guess this whole Jeffrey Epstein, this
mm-hmm.
whole situation about that, you know, I guess lawsuit or whatever it's going on, I don't know too much about
yeah, yeah.
it, but like Trump plays a huge part of it, and they released some, you know, documents saying that Trump donated this or Trump did this to a certain person or a certain, you know, young girl, and fucking Anonymous did that. And then how they're related to Russia and whatnot, and
yeah, yeah.
how Putin is like, what was Putin?
What do you mean, what is Putin?
Yeah, like Putin, the guy from Russia, right?
The
yeah.
president?
Yeah, right.
Russia?
Yeah, because
yeah.
they're beefing it at one point, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I think they still are.
No. They did something like an agreement where they lifted that. Oh. Or something like that. But yeah, Anonymous like leaked those documents out to the public.
You know, I never know who to believe. Like, no one. Because, like, someone, like, let's, for example, someone can say this. Oh, Trump does this, but he's such a bad person. He's this. And then someone else leaks something. They're like, no, he actually does this. But I'm like, what if you're just bullshitting too? Like, who the fuck? Why should I believe you? And why should I believe you?
Well, that's because politics is dirty. At the end of the day, politicians are dirty, either on the good side or the bad side. And that's why when they come out with ads, especially during when voting starts around that time, mm-hmm. you'll start to see those conflicting views of, you know, President Trump puts out something, but then the Democratic Party will be like, well, no, he has all this information, negative information. It's like, what side am I believing? Are you doing that to create actual validation and light on something he did that was bad? Or are you doing that just to gain a bad rep on him so it boosts your votes?
Yeah.
It's like, who do you believe in that instance?
Mm-hmm.
It's hard.
Yeah. And even when it's like not necessarily politics, but even when it's like, for example, let's say in politics they do say something, but for example, Brock just sent a video of this lady talking about all these conspiracies and this and that. So I get what you're saying. I don't why the fuck should I believe these politicians? But also, why should I believe this lady? Like, who the fuck is she? Like, I don't know who the hell you are.
She only has like a million views on YouTube.
Yeah. You know you have this following, so you can put your ideas on us. Like,
you're right.
Anything, you know?
You're right. You're absolutely
even
right.
When I'm listening to like someone who I love listening to, like for example, Joe Rogan. There's times where he'll say some things, and I have to kind of take a step back and understand that he's also spreading his opinion, so maybe what he's saying is not correct either. Just because it's Joe Rogan doesn't mean he knows everything and everything and anything that I should believe him, you know? So he could be saying his opinion, or who knows, he knows he has millions of viewers, so he knows that he's gonna want to imply certain things so his viewers kind of believe that as
lean
well
towards that way.
You get you know, and
have
I
have more of a following.
And so if Joe Rogan, let's say he wants Bernie Sanders to win, he'll imply little things. He'll influence. So I'll sometimes take a step back and be like, wait, this guy's also a person who knows who has influence, so he's probably not gonna
he'll put the good points and then he'll like
ignore some bad points.
Well, mm-hmm. What's the specific word, though, for when people do that? When they, well, like, they omit certain information that also goes to the opposing side.
Getting paid.
But, you have to actually critically think about the people you choose to listen to, then. It means, is this person, you ask the critical questions, is this person, what they're saying, good or bad? Like, is it something that I personally want to believe in? And then if I want to believe in it, why do I believe in it? And you have to continue to ask questions. If you're not asking questions, you're not being and thinking independently for yourself.
We all
need to be independent thinkers.
Damn. That hit right here.
That did, bro. I almost want to end the podcast right there. I know, dude. It's fucking crazy, the world we live in, man. I don't even know who the fuck to believe. We don't know who to believe, you know? Some people say one thing, other people say another. That's why I've kind of, not that I don't give a fuck about anybody else, but I've realized that when I was young, like a lot younger, I used to want to like change the world, you know? And I'm not saying that's not possible. All I'm saying is that I've realized the only people I can really affect are my immediate surroundings, my immediate circle. So I'm going to do what's best for my immediate circle, my immediate family. I'm not here to change the world or anything. I have to do what's best for it. I mean, I guess it sounds selfish, but
I disagree. Because then it's the debate question, which most of you have heard. Do you think one voice matters? Do you think one vote, one voice matters? Because I used to have the pessimistic view of, well, I'm only one person. I'm only one voice. I'm only one vote. And how does one vote outweigh millions?
Mm-hmm.
But there are millions of votes. There are millions of votes from positive people that also want to make a change. So if they have chosen to say that they're one voice, it's all about you. Hmm. At the end of the day, you're saying, oh, I can only affect my family.
No, what if you affected, say, me, and I'm over here saying what you have taught me and I've learned about whatever the situation is, and I go spread it to you, and then right. You do the same. Mm. You spread it to...
You're what we call immediate is way more bigger than we think it is. Because if I'm a positive person, and I put, like Rick said, the same views on him, and then he's like, actually, you're right. I'm going to now talk to my friends about it and give them my view, and then they positively change their minds. And that is what the trickle effect of change is. And mm-hmm. That's when your one voice turns does matter, yeah, and it turns yep. into many. So the voting, the speaking out against political issues or personal issues, you have to, because your one voice matters. And if none of us spoke up, then nothing would happen. Mm-hmm. If I chose to say my voice matters, and you chose to say your voice matters, and you, and so on and so forth, yeah,
three, no.
Then we have more than one voice. Mm-hmm. We have millions of voices.
Do you think that's why people tend to not speak up? Because they'll be like, hey, I'm only one. And they'll be like, it's not going to make a difference. So I just,
yeah. I think people are scared.
Yes. Yeah, exactly.
People are scared to open up because they're scared of what other people think of them. Mm-hmm. So that's why they keep it to themselves, or they just rather not say anything at all.
Yeah. You know, even if you're a good person in your heart and you're like if the person says, well, you know, if they get down and they're like, well, my voice doesn't matter. But inside they're like, you know, I positively want to make a change, or I agree with what these other people who have the courage to speak out are saying, then there's no reason that you shouldn't speak out. Mm-hmm. And if it affects your family, or your family members have different views, it's hard and it's difficult, but it has to be done. It's your opinion. Your opinion is no less or more important than your opinion. Mm-hmm. You know, mine doesn't matter as much as your matters more.
Yeah.
So either speak it or don't speak it.
Have you guys ever like hesitated to say something because you're scared of maybe criticism
or conflict?
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because I just recently did it, but then I'm a big person who I talk shit on myself all the time, and that's my motivator. And I've said it a bunch of times on this podcast that if I'm not satisfied because I've gained weight, I'll look in the mirror and be like, look at you, you fat piece of shit. Like, I'll talk shit on myself like that, right? And then I just did a podcast by myself that I haven't released yet. That's the next one that's going to come out. And then after that one, it's going to be this one. But I was speaking on the George Floyd situation, right? Mm-hmm. But then when I was editing it and doing all that stuff, I almost didn't want to, like, put it out in public, because I almost said, like, what if I said the wrong thing? What if I'm going to offend people? Or even though I don't think I did, but that mind crossed my mind. And mm-hmm. I was like, it's tough times, so people aren't thinking rational.
No, right.
So what if people, like, what if I said one little thing? Well, no, me being a big jokester and prankster, the way I cope with depressing stuff is
through jokes.
That's just, I just don't like to think of the sadness of it, you know? So I use jokes to make me feel good, you know? So I started thinking, what if people get offended just because I'm making little funny jokes, you know? But then I overcame myself by saying, dude, fuck that. Like, you're allowed to say what you want, you know? And I don't believe I said anything bad. So I kind of just, I pushed on through, and I'm still going to release it. And I'm probably making this a bigger deal than it really is. I probably
just something small. Nothing. Yeah, it doesn't even like bring to the point. You're just like, I was overreacting.
Yeah, I was overreacting. But like I'm saying, I had that feeling, but then I was like, nah, fuck that, dude. Just like Emily said, like, we're all entitled to our opinion. Yeah. We're all like, you know. So I shouldn't be scared of what people are gonna think of me. There's other people that think like me, where they're like, I don't like to think of this sadness. So a little joke, a little here and there, laughter right. is gonna make me feel better, you know.
Right.
Without being an asshole, you know. Without being
that guy.
No, without being like an actual racist or mm-hmm. being an actual douchebag, you know. Right. Because everything, the jokes I make is just to be funny. I'm not.
Right.
Really. Dude, being an asshole. You should be
a comedian.
Bro, I haven't had the balls to get on stage.
Oh, fuck yeah. Like Emily said.
Why'd you bring that up, bro? Fuck. I'm sorry. You know I'm very sensitive about
that. I'm just kidding. No, that brings up a good point about, like, how there's people that take it a certain way. People that, like, oh, you know what? He is right. That because of the situation right now, they aren't thinking straight. And they're probably just activated or like, engaged. Like, you know what? Fuck this guy.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? So, like, for example, like, Trump said something about, oh, something about looting and thugs.
Oh, yeah.
And people took it the wrong way. I was like, yeah, protesting shouldn't be about looting, you know, businesses or even destroying, you know, people's cars or whatnot. It should be, like, you know, for the people. Shouldn't be about violence. But then again, Trump said that and people were taking it the wrong way because he was targeting, like, I guess, you know, the black people.
Yeah.
And people took it the wrong way, which he wasn't. But then again, he could have worded it differently.
Mm-hmm.
And
you know... Hold on, I made a little joke. I said, I feel bad for the guy who's like, who was at work in his office, and he comes out to his fucking car being on its side.
Oh, bro.
He's like, what the fuck? Oh, you fucking assholes. You know,
have you seen
how they rock cars back and forth until it flips
over?
Have
you seen that Mexican in LA? There's this Mexican that was going to his car, and he found out that his car was burnt.
Mm-hmm.
Like, destroyed completely. Yeah, toasted.
Poor guy, dude.
Yeah. And he was fucking obviously devastated by it. He didn't know what to do. But he went back to get his little garage entrance, you know, the clicker?
Yeah.
For his garage. And what's it called? I guess there's some people there, some protesters there that were recording him, you know, and talking to him and whatnot. And they ended up starting a GoFundMe page. And right now, I think he had 60K donated. To get a new car.
60K. Jeez, what do you have? Like
a Nissan. Like just a 2008 Nissan.
I said
or
he actually, it was actually a positive.
Yeah, this motherfucker came up, bro.
Yeah, so I'm like,
but
fuck.
There is a difference between protesting and riots.
Yeah.
And there have been both during this time. There have been peaceful protests and there have been riots. And the people that are rioting are not for the movement. They actually, I was watching a video of an officer who was telling peaceful protesters, hey, you need to move away from these people over here who are rioting and causing issues, because that officer went up to them and said, do you even know why you're here or doing this? And they're like, do you know who George Floyd is? They're like, no, we have no idea.
Mm-hmm.
So they have no idea why they're out. They just know that there's chaos happening and they want to go out and destroy things. Where the peaceful protesters and
they're ruining it for them.
Yeah.
And media does not help.
Oh, hell no. Hell no.
Only it's propaganda. And if you know propaganda, it means that something is all this information negatively is being put in your face to make it seem like this is what the majority of what's happening.
Well, the media wants to lit news, you know? They want like, oh, fire or like, you know, destruction, you know, this. Because they do it for the views.
And they do it for the views. And not only that, but they do it because they don't want to support the movement.
They're selfish.
Well, these media outlets like CNN, Fox News, like all these people are run by who? Who do you think? White people. And whatever their views are trickles down to their station.
Yeah.
So if they say, hey, we are only covering these riots and the negative things that are happening, then it puts a bad light on the movement, it puts a bad light on the peaceful protest, and it then in turn enhances white supremacy, saying we still are not going to give you your voice. And that in doing that, we're going to put all this negative propaganda out there, which is really fucked up.
Yeah, wait, if you say it's run by like white people, then why would there be headlines of like, well, maybe it's not
100%.
Yeah.
It's 100%.
Yeah.
Because they are like,
obviously they're not gonna have an all white employees. Obviously.
No.
Yeah.
I'm just saying there is gonna be a top guy.
Yeah.
I'm not saying, and I know their views, but we have to look at that top guy and if he is white, if he is not white, and what are his views, because that is gonna trickle down to his station.
Yeah.
But there are really great news medias and outlets out there that have positive headlines, positive titles.
Right, because at the end of the day, he chooses what his viewers are going to see.
Mm-hmm. And obviously, those good ones don't get as much views as the bad ones because that doesn't sell. For God's sake, people can't even...
Sell.
Someone can't even have a flat tire on the side of the road with people like, oh, what the fuck happened over there, you know? And it's just a flat... Dude, there's times where I'm like, oh, shit, a car accident. No wonder there's traffic. And then I pass it. This motherfucker just... pop this tire. Hurry the fuck up. Road. Yeah, like, Jesus, man.
Like, it's like 2 miles of traffic, and as soon as you pass that one guy with one tire change, it all goes smooth.
Yeah, yeah, I'm like, fucking guys. What, you know, I had a little, I'm not saying rioting is a good thing. I'm not saying go do it. But to a certain degree, I kind of understood them only because I was like, people are angry, you know?
But are you sure they're angry for the right reason?
Well, I'm not saying everyone is. I'm not saying everyone. Mm-hmm. But I'm assuming there are some people out there who want to break a glass window because they're so pissed off. Like, dude, when my girlfriend pisses me off, I want to sock a wall, you know? Mm-hmm. So if when people are tired of something happening a bunch of times,
they get mad,
and when you get mad, you're not thinking rational. No. So I'm not saying it's a good thing. I'm just saying that to a certain degree, I understand why some of them will riot because of this, because they're
because
angry
yeah.
and
because
they're fucking tired of it, you know?
Yeah, you know what's been happening lately? The peaceful protesters, when they see someone vandalizing or even, like, you know, looting, mm-hmm. they grab that guy or girl, whatever it is, whatever they are, they grab them and throw them to the cops.
Oh, really?
Yeah, to authority. And then they take it from there. And then it's been like that now. They haven't really looted or whatever. Mm. And a lot of in HB, I forgot where I heard this from. I don't know if it's true or not. But in HB, the people that own businesses there mm-hmm. are outside of their stores with guns.
Oh,
protecting
yeah.
Protecting it.
Yeah. I saw that shit. I couldn't even get to work. I clean an
office
right there.
Yeah.
I couldn't get there, bro. But yeah, dude, it's been fucking wild. I wonder how many people have COVID-19 now because of all that shit. You
didn't
know?
You say that the percentage went up?
What?
COVID-19?
Well,
keep talking. I'm just going.
Chickity bum. Chickity bum. Chickity bum. Chickity bum. Bum 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 bum.
Half my face will be in
check
the
it.
What were you saying?
Only this part of your face.
Yeah. The good side, at least.
No, so obviously it is also the time of COVID-19. Mm-hmm. And the opening of the United States is in progress. And as we start to open, obviously officials and health officials have been asking, okay, do we think this is an appropriate time to start reopening America? Because COVID-19 is still out there. Mm-hmm. It's still a thing.
Yeah.
And now, obviously, with the protesting and everybody out, definitely not 6 feet apart, millions and millions of people, it brought up, like, some statistics of, okay, the COVID-19 was kind of going down, but then we opened some restaurants and bars and barbershops and hairdressers, and it kind of spiked, mm-hmm. leveled off, and now we have these protests. And I actually am not sure of that statistics of what it's going to look like after everybody being in close quarters from protesting.
Just imagine protesters following those rules and trying to be 6 feet apart from each other.
I do not. I believe that I have the news updates on my phone, and I did get a news update that I read the article, and that there was a second autopsy done on George Floyd, because the first one is done by usually the police department's whoever they have in line with their police mm-hmm. department, their autopsy. Mm-hmm. And they said that he did not die of asphyxiation, which is pressure on the neck.
Yeah.
And then when George Floyd's family brought him, because it's expensive, very, very expensive to get an autopsy done. But with the money raised, they took George Floyd and got their own private mm-hmm. autopsy done. He did die of asphyxiation, mm-hmm. and he had coronavirus.
Oh, wow, really?
Yes. Yes. So,
damn.
I mean, if those cops were in close quarters...
So you're saying you hope they have them too? They have it too?
I would never wish anything on anybody, but that just, I mean...
I'll say it for you. We do.
Everyone says that we do.
Yeah. But I think, honestly, if the more we start to learn about COVID-19 and that it is a scary... I mean, it was scary. I think now the more it comes to light, well, it's kind of like the flu, or, hey, the only percentage of people who have passed away have been the older, 80 and older. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, it's still something to be conscious of. But as the vaccines rise, it's just the next move. It's just the next...
And you know what's scary about that? I have a friend. His name is Jerry. He's working with my buddy Chris that owns a moving distribution or truck basically moving merchandise. And they were in LA doing a job in a hospital. And I guess their doctors were in break outside, and my friend confronts the doctor and tells him, hey, you know, I was like, is it really that bad? You know, he's like, man, the amount of bodies, I was like, are just piling up in the trucks. Yeah. Yeah. I was just like, and he panicked. He's like, damn, are you serious? He's like, yeah, people aren't taking it serious. I was like, they think it's a joke, but if they only see what I see in the hospital, I was just like, Jesus Christ. So he's a lot more cautious and a lot more, like, you know, preserved. He's like, nah, don't touch me,
and
man.
And that's the other side, is that if we don't work in a hospital or we not know nurses or doctors who have first-handedly dealt with this, they are seeing way more amount of pain than we are seeing on the media. So they, of course, are going to have a very different view.
Oh, yeah.
It's just...
Imagine going to work and just thinking that, like, you might die today?
Well, they're putting catch COVID-19? They're putting themselves at risk. 100%. They're putting themselves at risk. And we do not fund them like we should.
Yeah, we do.
Like, well,
we they're do. Balling. Have you seen the college they're trying?
We do, but when you're telling me the whole of America can't get their hands on respirators or quality.
Okay. I thought you meant like
fun them with equipment.
Yeah, yeah, with like
proper equipment.
Oh, I was thinking.
No. But then
again, in general, they are very funded.
Yeah, I was we pay doctors pretty
But then
well.
Again, I was like, no one was expecting this, so no one was prepared. So how are we going to expect every hospital to have all these supplies ready to go?
We don't, but we are hoping, like, when these places, hey, government, we need this amount of respirators, we need this amount of masks and equipment and gear for
what are you gonna do about it?
Nurses and doctors. And when they say, hey, we can't get them because some other guy who is monopolizing on all of it wants to put up the prices.
Not even.
Oh, now we're in need. Think about that one person who's like, I'm not going to give these people the equipment they need because I'm a right.
No, because the majority of the equipment we get is from China. How are we going to get the stuff from China if they're in lockdown themselves? And maybe, shit, one of the fucking respirators has, you know, bacteria of COVID-19, and everyone's fucked.
I don't think that's how that works.
I'm just saying. I'm just imagining shit. But yes, most of our medical equipment, medicine, is created in China.
Well, for mass production. Think about the vaccine. So all these doctors are racing to find the vaccine. That's what they're doing all over the world, because they want to be the doctor that finds the cure, the vaccine for the coronavirus. But these medical centers and testing centers have profited off of the coronavirus. They have gotten, we got what, a $1,200 stimulus check and $600 extra a week for unemployment. You know what they got? This one guy went from, like, his net worth, because he owns a vaccine company. His network was below $1 billion. I think it was like 800, 900 million. And within the first week of coronavirus happening, his network went above $1 billion. And now it's at $2.1 billion because the government gave him $400 billion to invest. And not necessarily just in the vaccine, but to make him richer. It is This coronavirus is making the richer richer, and the least they can give us is a $1,200 stimulus check.
I see what you're saying.
Yeah, which means they're profiting, and like, so he might have gone $400 billion for his business, but now his net worth, personal net worth, rose over $1 billion.
He's probably
and we got shit. Damn. Now, I don't know if you follow Bernie Sanders on social media, but you should. Very because Bernie Sanders is totally, like, all his beliefs is completely against government taking more than they should. That he will bring into light, if you listen to what he says, he shoots facts and only facts about the way the government handles their money and how much they keep from us.
So don't you think he's the Democratic version of Trump? Because that's basically what Trump does, but he's a Republican, because I feel like Trump is pretty straight up too. And he's not receiving any fund. Like, I mean, I'm not, again, I'm not in the fucking circle, but he's like, he's calling out fake news all the time. He's saying he's tired of all these fake news because I'm saying a certain thing and they twist my words around. So I look like a bad guy, but I'm just calling them out on their bullshit. So he's being straight up as well. He's just a Republican. Calling
out some fake news, which is it really fake news? Because if you read his tweets, he digs his own grave. Like, you cannot fake what you put out on social media. Mm-hmm. And I'm sorry, but I can't believe in a guy who calls out fake news. So, like, let's say he calls out somebody
her
who's
tweets.
Let's say he calls out somebody for doing fake news. Mm-hmm. So you're saying, like, okay, yeah, so Trump brings to light these people who are saying fake news. But Trump himself has also put out tweets of his own words. Mm-hmm. And when read back to him, I didn't say that. There is a little literal video of tweets of he said being read back to him. Nope, wasn't me. Like, it is you. It is completely you. And now when people throw back your own words, you're like, oh, it's fake news.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you want to know why, though?
You put out the news, but now it's fake.
But I'm thinking,
so now I'm just saying as a person, how do I validate what he's saying when he's calling out other people?
You're right. Just like, I think if you're in that position, I feel like other people are in charge of what
he says.
But he, and you so, know he doesn't, right? It's all his own words.
I know, but that's what I'm trying to say is, like, what if it isn't him? You know, what if his, like, assistant, like, tweets it, you know?
I don't think he physically does it, because I remember I saw an interview with Obama on Jimmy Kimmel, I think. And then he asked him, like, do you tweet to fans or do you tweet at all? He's like, in general, I don't tweet. I'm not even allowed to have a phone. I'm not even allowed to have a phone that you guys have. I have a phone with no microphone. Like, I have a BlackBerry. So he said the only time I'll tweet would be if it's for a special event, like something special, only because I want people to kind of interact with me. But other than that, in general, I do not post any tweets myself.
So what if Trump was being literal, though? So let's say all those tweets are definitely Trump's words. So let's say they do go through somebody, and I told you, Rick, hey, this is what I'm gonna say.
You cannot
disagree with me. This is what I want to say.
And like, fine.
The person doesn't vet it, which means the person is not gonna re-edit it. He's gonna put it exactly like he wrote it. Yeah. So in literal sense, Trump could say, I didn't write that.
Mm-hmm.
Because maybe he did say it, but it's getting vetted through somebody else.
But he didn't write that.
And he won't be lying.
Physically write it, so then he won't be lying. Mm-hmm. He's a smart, and this is why I'm saying, Trump's not dumb. He's very, very smart. Mm-hmm. He's a businessman for a reason.
Yeah.
But then again, he's definitely saying those words.
Damn, I gotta take notes if I want to be successful now.
Yeah. You have to also be fucking rich. Because he funds all his campaigns.
Yeah, I mean,
he does,
because he also gets a lot of donations.
Because that's why he says a lot of shit, because he can't, because he funds his own campaigns. He can say whatever the fuck he wants to say. Unlike, say, for example, someone else.
But should, that's the question. But should he might call people out? He might say this, but as a leader of this entire country, a leader who should not only, be fighting for Hispanics, mm-hmm. be fighting for women's rights, the LGBTQ community, blacks, Asians, Native Americans, I can go on. I'm sorry if I missed you. But he should be fighting for everybody. And in that sense, that's the president. That is the standard.
You're right.
It's not even that. It's a standard for our president to keep in mind of everybody. That's the role that you take on. So, yes, mm-hmm. if you want to call someone out on their bullshit, that's fine. But to the extent of your words matter, because mm-hmm. you are the president of the United States. Yeah. They are the most meaningful words that someone will say. So the fact that he doesn't defend everybody and he's not for everybody, he's not for me.
I get what you're saying.
He's a cock.
So he should be doing what I was doing when I didn't want to post my thing, because I'm like, wait, what if it offends people? What if I didn't say it right?
Who probably
but
says
you know what
it
that's called?
Then
it's
and
called
there?
Being human is because that shows your personality. Is that, you know what? That second questioning is good. Mm-hmm. That's called vetting yourself. Is that, is this gonna offend somebody? And if it is going to offend somebody, even if it's my opinion, is it right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's the question. Like, we can't be horrible human beings where we don't think about the next person or our neighbor mm-hmm. or another person of a different race or gender. We have to consciously think, okay, what I'm saying is my opinion, and that's fine. Mm-hmm. But is it right, and is it something that I want to offend my neighbor or my friend about?
Yeah.
Because that's what makes us human. That's what makes us have compassion. Mm-hmm. And I would never want to say my opinion if it offended a friend, if it offended somebody, a stranger.
You know, let me read you this quote that I saw. Somebody posted online, and it's so true. It says, opinion is really the lowest form of human knowledge. Mm-hmm. It requires no accountability, no understanding. The highest form of knowledge is empathy, for it requires us to suspend our egos and live in others' worlds. In another's world, it requires profound purpose larger than self kind of understanding. And I agree,
exactly,
because if you have empathy, you're setting your ego completely aside to understand someone else's situation. Mm-hmm. Whereas if you're just giving only opinion, you're not trying to understand the other person. Mm-hmm. You're just saying, like, what the fuck I think. This is what I think, and this is what I stand for, blah, 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 blah. Which is good, but at the same time, you have to take a step back sometimes and be like, you know what, let me try to understand what this person is going through, what they're trying to say. Because, you know, if you're already going in hard-headed, mm-hmm. then there's no point of arguing with anybody, you know?
Because you're going to continue to believe what you believe. It's mm-hmm. not going to change your mind. Mm-hmm. But being educated and critically thinking about, hey, I believe this. The best part of a debate is when you can believe what you believe, and if you don't want to change, that's fine, but actively seeking another person's view to be able to listen to what they have to say. Like, okay, I hear you. And it might change your mind. What are you worried? Sometimes people are so worried that another person's view could possibly change their opinion. Because mm-hmm. they think they're so right that they don't want to listen to what anybody has to say. Because God forbid,
it'll change yours. Wow. That's funny.
That's why we should.
Crazy, man.
That is fucking crazy. I know. People are a bunch of
fucking
assholes.
Well, why don't I want to hear this person out, huh? Mm-hmm. Why wouldn't you want to hear them out? Because if you really think, oh, you're not going to change my opinion, then why not listen?
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. And then if it changes your opinion, you just become a better, more elevated human being.
And knowledgeable.
Yeah. That's all it is. We're selfish, opinionated human beings. That's how we were made.
We're born this way.
You know what's something that I love, even though it hurts in the moment, but then in the long run, I love it? I'm very outspoken myself. I like to call people out on their shit all the time. So when people call me out on my shit, in the moment, it's kind of hurtful because you don't want to hear it sometimes.
You want to be that person to call them
out. You know, nobody likes being wrong, you know? So in the moment, if someone calls me out on my bullshit, I kind of like, oh, I get defensive, you know, for a little bit. But then I'm like, I like that. I like mm-hmm. that because if I'm willing to call people out on their shit, I should be able to also take the hit, you know, right. when I'm wrong. So when someone calls me out on my shit, I'm like, ah, fuck. I'm mad that you're wrong. I mean, I'm mad that you're right. You know, I'm mad that the other mm-hmm. person's right and they called me and I'm wrong and they called me out on my shit. But then I'll be like, I'm glad. I'm glad that they called me out because that they checked me. That person just checked me. Like, my girlfriend does that to me, you know, like, she checked me, therefore I became a better person, you get what I'm saying? Because mm-hmm. probably what I was doing was wrong. You know,
and she called you out.
And she called me out on my bullshit. You know, and it's fucking, yeah.
It's
just understanding of others. But I think we've come to the end of this podcast, guys. This card, it's probably gonna end the last 5 minutes with no visual, which is all right because I know this one just ran out of memory, and that I don't know about that one. But when I went to go check up on it, we've noticed that half my face was probably being mm-hmm. recorded. So. But that's all right. All right, guys. Well, I enjoyed talking with Emily and Rick, and you're going to see them on the podcast more often. Yeah. And I'll see you guys on the next one, guys. Peace.